must have been 1951. I was involved in a Friends Service Council bring and buy sale. It's a Bourneville Meeting House, and there's a special event there. They got someone who was going to work in India, was going to come and sing as part of the do to raise money, of course. And it turned out it was Eric. And then I've got a mental picture, a very clear mental picture of this woman who was Eric's wife standing in the doorway at Bourneville Meeting House with a rather unhappy child in her arms. And it stuck in my mind. I didn't realise the significance at the time, but it stayed with me. I'd been tipped off there was a vacancy at Resulia, and I wrote to Friends Service Council to see whether there's any opportunity for service via them. And I got back a rather dusty letter. So no, we don't take COs. Try FAU, which of course I'd already done. And of course, Christopher Taylor was chairman of India Committee at Friends Service Council at that time. And he was also a member of Bourneville Meeting. And he knew obviously what was going on. And he must have, I'm pretty sure he did, make the suggestion that I might be suitable to go to Resulia. I remember Jack Norton, who was General Secretary of the FA, come along to me one day and said, how do you fancy going to India? I said, yes, please. I went to Woodbrook to learn a bit about India, learn about the conditions, gave me a list of books to read. I was there to the end of that term in December. By that time, I'd had a smattering of Hindi, a very small amount of Hindi. I'd learned to drive, passed my driving test, and was ready to go. All signed up to sail from Tilbury on, I think, the 30th of December 1953. We were met in Bombay by Pratap, and we had an overnight journey to Resulia on a train. And travelling by train in India is quite an experience. We got to Hoshangabad early afternoon, and the Donald Groom and one or two others had come down in a car to meet us off the train, took us up to Resulia. You know, this was the beginning of a different world altogether. Eventually met Eric and Ruth and Anne and Mark. And obviously Ian wasn't very far away, but not very visible. Then I started work there. My job there was, as the engineer, it was my job to look after all the equipment, sort out the problems with the cars and the water pumps and the other bits and pieces, and help local farmers as far as I could with their equipment. One chap who had a diesel pump and had spent an awful lot of time sorting that out because he hadn't any feeling or sense about mechanical things. There was another farmer there who had a David Brown tractor, and I spent a fair amount of time sorting that out one way and the other. Although other people there as well, Ralph Rosedale had got there just before I did. I'd met him in Birmingham while I was still at Woodbrook. He was an American friend from California. A bit later on, Wendell Motta joined us. And then much later still, we had Ralph Way, all COs who were doing their alternative service. And of course, there was John Foster, who was coming to the end of his 2 years service out there, another American friend, and I inherited his office and his typewriter and took over the workshop that he'd built up while he was there. I enjoyed the time in India without any doubt. It was a complete eye-opening experience, living close to small children, which I'd not had any experience of before. The children running around and enjoying themselves and coming into my office, which was directly attached to their bungalow, and poking around, looking at this and playing with that, and asking questions and what have you. Particularly Mark and Ian, when Ian was mobile. I think he commented on one letter that he came into my office and wanted to help me type the letter, which I was writing a letter home to Dad, or rather to Fred, and ended up getting covered in ink off the typewriter ribbon. I'd got an interest in photography, which I shared with Eric, and we had arranged to have the Amateur Photographer magazine sent out by sea, and so when they came, they usually came in three and four at a time, we'd avidly go through these and look at all the latest techniques and all the new equipment and think of what we'd like, and quite good fun.